We can rotate the element using the rotate x, rotate y, and rotate z functions. Alternatively, the same effect can be achieved using the matrix and matrix 3D functions. All we have to do is apply some formulas. We can rotate this 2D element by using the matrix function. First of all, let's learn how to calculate rotate or rotate z in matrix function. We can achieve rotate z in matrix function by using this formula, or we can put the formula this way. I have kept here 0 for both the translate x and translate y parameters so that we can see the rotations very clearly. We can use this matrix function to calculate the rotations in a 2D element. Let's say we want to calculate rotate z 35 degrees. To do that, we have to find out the sine and cosine values outlined in this formula. Now I will show you how to calculate cos theta and sine theta. Search on Google as calculator to find the values of sine theta and cos theta. This calculator defaults to radians, but since we are calculating rotations in degrees, we have to switch to degrees. To switch to degrees, simply click here on deg. Since we are going to calculate rotate z 35 degrees, we can replace all the theta values with 35 as shown here. Now all we have to do is find out cos 35 and sine 35. First, let's calculate cos 35. Click on cos, then enter 35. Now we have obtained the value of cos 35, which is 0.8191. We have rounded the result to 4 decimal places. Now enter the value of cos 35 in both the first and fourth parameters. Similarly, we can calculate sine 35. Click on sine followed by 35. The value of sine 35 is 0.5735. Enter the value of sine 35 in both the second and third parameters. This value is equivalent to rotate z 35 degrees. You may also represent the rotate z 35 degrees as shown here. This technique works in a 2D element as well, but not necessarily required to be used this way as it involves lengthy parameters primarily intended for 3D elements. In short, these formulas are used for calculating rotate x, y, and z on a 2D plane. The first two formulas will produce the same effects as rotate x and rotate y on a 2D plane, but they will not work with a 3D element. Only the rotate z formula works with a 3D element. The matrix function alone cannot accurately represent the rotate x and rotate y transformations. The matrix function is a 2D transformation function that accepts 6 values representing a 3x3 matrix. It can handle translation, scaling, skewing, and rotation in the 2D plane, but it does not support 3D rotations around the X or Y axis. Therefore, you can use these formulas to create the rotations in matrix 3D function. To reverse the direction of rotations in matrix function, you simply need to change this first sine value to negative and then change the second sine value to positive. If it is in a matrix 3D function, you make the upper sine value negative and the lower sine value positive. That's it. With this, I hope that you will be able to calculate the rotations in matrix function and matrix 3D function. If you have any questions, please leave your questions in the comment box below. Thanks for watching and goodbye for now until next time.